Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to my channel. In this short tip, I will show you guys with the help of gradient map how we can create this type of cool effects for a grayscale image in Adobe Photoshop. So let's get started. Alright guys, so this is our image source. First thing what I'm going to do is I want to make this image, especially these mid-tones, a little bit more lighter. The highlighted areas in here are fine and the dark shadows are fine too. So I will go into adjustment layers. In here, I'm going to apply a levels. Okay, so let's bring the mid-tones in here to a little bit more lighter, somewhere around here. I think this is fine. And for the highlighted areas, I will make them a little bit more darker. Okay, little bit like that. All right, I think this is good enough. And now we are going to apply another filter which will pick the effect we are looking for. That is, when you go in here to the adjustment filter again, you have to choose the gradient map, which is this one. Okay, not the gradient map. Okay, so when you choose the gradient map, by default, it will apply this black and white as a gradient map. How this work is pretty simple. When you open this gradient in here, you will see this is the starting point of the gradient and this is the ending point of this gradient. So basically how this works is the starting point, the darkest point now, will apply the color to the darkest shadow in your images. And the end point in here will apply the colors to the lightest areas in your images. For an example, let's say you want to apply a color for this highlighted area, which is this one in here, and in here, and here, and these areas. You just need to apply a color to here. As of now, our white is already been applied, but we don't see any difference because our original image looks the same. So all I need to do is double click to open the gradient. Let's say I want to apply a yellow color. I will go into the yellow color in here and apply a yellow color like this. As you guys can see, this yellow color has been applied to these light areas, and these areas, the mid-tone areas, also getting the color from the gradient in here. We can always change that also. Let's add a new gradient point in the mid-tone in here. And for this, double click again. Let's say for these areas, I want to apply a red color. I can go in here and apply a red color like this. Okay. And for the shadows, these darker areas, I have to choose the first gradient point in here and double click to open, and we can apply the color. Let's say I want a purple color, something like that. We can apply the color like this. Okay. And if you guys go into the image, you can see we have applied these colors nicely with the gradient map. All right. You guys can always select the gradient map and go in here and change the colors if you want to. You guys can make it darker or lighter based on your preference. And also you can add in more colors if you want to. Let's say you want to have a color in between these highlights and this red area midtones. You can always add a new color in here. You can see it's applying this new color in here. You can always double click and change the colors the way you want it. All right, you can make it lighter or darker. It's up to you guys. And to get best results for this kind of artworks, always try to apply lighter colors for lighter areas, highlight areas in your picture, and darker tones for darker areas, shadow areas in your picture. All right, so once you're satisfied, just select OK and OK. We have this nice effect to our photo. You guys can create so many different variations with this gradient map, and you can always go in here to the gradient again. And let's say if I want to apply a gradient from the presets, I go in here. If I apply this color in here, you can see theme of the image is totally changing, and we can make this one a little bit more darker as well. So you guys can play around with these gradient settings and create so many different types of cool looking artworks like this using gradient maps. Alright guys, that's all about it for today. And in our final artwork, in addition to these settings, I have applied a camera raw filter for this original image. Double click the image, unlock the layer, and go to filters and select camera raw filter. And in here, I have applied a green effect, something along here, and applied the effect. With the green effect, our image will look even more nicer, especially in these highlights areas. Okay. Alright guys, that's all about it for today's short tip. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.